You're watching UNICEF Television.
Every day, Halima Abdikadir, a mother of four, walks for 2 kilometres to fetch firewood in the bushes on the outskirts of Mogadishu. It's a risky journey for Halima, who knows that each time she comes to these areas, she could be attacked or raped. Girls and women in Mogadishu say they're at greatest threat of sexual violence while they're collecting firewood, so they make sure they stay together. Up to now, Halima has had no choice. She's a widow, and her family were displaced by the famine in southern Somalia last year. They now stay in a camp near Mogadishu.
We collect this firewood from very far. We are afraid of getting attacked or raped. Sometimes when we go, some people refuse to allow us to pick firewood in the area. We don't have stores to use. Therefore, we have no option but to go and collect firewood from the bush.
UNICEF and its partners hope that a new project to provide fuel-efficient stoves to displaced families will reduce or eliminate the need to collect firewood. One partner, Relief International, put on a play to show the displaced at this camp how the fuel-saving stoves work. The stoves burn waste products, such as maize husks, and are less harmful to health than traditional open fires.
These stoves will help change the lives of the people because it will reduce their vulnerabilities. We're hoping to go and collect firewood. It will reduce the amount of firewood they need on a weekly basis. It will reduce the number of times they need to go out and collect firewood, which would in turn reduce the number, the potential risks that they would face while collecting firewood and going out.
More than 16,000 stoves are being distributed in Mogadishu to vulnerable families and those looking after more than 8 children. Halima was among the lucky ones.
I thank God for what we have received today. We have been brought a stove that uses less firewood. When we light it, the time we wait for the fire to get ready is fast, and we can use it 5 to 6 times more than the previous way of cooking.
Some of the stoves are actually produced by internally displaced persons or IDPs living in Mogadishu. It's a project that provides more than 150 families with an income. In Siliga camp, UNICEF partner Mercy Corps is training men and women how to make the fuel-efficient stoves. Women are shown how to make the inside part of the stove made from clay. As well as making stoves, Hawa Mohammed now uses one for her cooking.
This stove has changed my life. It has reduced my expenses and the cooking difficulties I used to have. If I return to my village, I'm not going to stop using this stove. Even for my friends who don't know about this stove, I'm going to teach them about it so that it can help them.
The young men learn how to weld scrap metal to make the outside cover for the stoves. Omar Ali believes this will provide him with a good livelihood in the future.
I have learned the skills of making the stove. I know how I can start earning out of it. I know the losses and the gains of the business, so the knowledge I gained here will be beneficial.
Young girls in the camps for the displaced face daily risks to their personal safety and security. Girls under 14 are often called on to collect firewood for cooking, while their brothers do casual labour. The fuel-efficient stoves will not only reduce the need for this risky activity, but UNICEF hopes will also give the girls enough free time to return to school and continue their education. This is Susannah Price reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to www.unicef.org.
You've been watching UNICEF Television.